Even since it's very staggering. My hopes that Reze would end up like a nice girl, would end up being good for Denji, is going that way. They have a really nice interactions relationship that we got, so far in the last couple chapters. But the thing is, the author isn't a nice guy to characters that aren't required. Let's just go with that. Because now he's setting up this girl while having some spooky dude who's got a contract with Typhoon Devil to go after him because he's going after the heart of the chainsaw. But here we have Reze and Denji sneaking into the school at night, wherever she goes to school, and you got this really nice panel. And she looks so happy, holding Denji's hand. She's just getting ready to go do some fun stuff with him. She's gonna teach him some stuff because he never went to school. And I did really like the part when it was just some of their lessons. She's got like 1 + 1, and she's like freaking out, like asking her to pick him. It's 2, and very obvious. I just like Denji's enthusiasm in that. And then she writes out in English. She writes big ass, and he doesn't really know what it is, but he still wants to answer anyway. And he ends up calling her a pervert for what she wrote. But, they're just having fun. They're just having a good time with each other. Some. Not terrible kid stuff, sneaking into schools. I mean, as long as they're not breaking things, stealing anything, too bad. Anyway, then, she's like talking to him about like the fact he never went to school, which means she doesn't know about like his youth, how he grew up, what he had to go through in the younger David's life, like why he worked so much. Like, he probably doesn't even know. Like, she probably hasn't even told the fact that like for years and years, like all they did all day, every day was just work, make money, and then give it to somebody else, like barely getting to eat, barely getting to do anything. Like, she's saying like how it's messing up that he pretty much does like he didn't go to school, not even grade school, and he everyone else that she knows at this age is like getting ready for college, doing whatever they can to kind of like push their lives forward. But here's Denji out like hunting devils and almost getting himself killed every day, which the fact she says almost getting killed, she probably doesn't know that he's immortal. We don't know if he's unaging. I assume he's unaging because, immortality, and it just seems to probably fit in with a long line with it. I guess we don't really know enough about devils to really know about their agingness. We just know that outside of messing with his heart, it doesn't look like he could die. But like Denji's just really happy because he's saying like, yeah, I really like what I do. I get 3 meals a day, and he gets to sleep in a bed. He's got a place. I mean, she's just saying like that's the bare minimum of standard living in Japan, and it's not amazing. The thing is, it's amazing for Denji because he grew up like below nothing. The dude, I mean, he didn't have technically like nothing at all. He literally, what was it? He lived in a tiny little wooden shack with, like, I think it was just one room. I don't even think he had a bathroom. He probably had to go outside, probably had to like bathe in a river. There wasn't a whole lot for the life of Denji. It was all rough, not fun, just an all around not enjoyable place. Like, it barely looked like even had somewhere to sleep. It just looks like some raggedy box that he was not good for him. He's always like leaning up against like crates and grates and barely able to like fully stretch his legs. Like, it was just not good for him. Dude had really nothing. He was just eating plain bread with his dog every day. So for him, something like that where you're just barely getting what people would see as like this the necessary like requirements, it is great for him. I really hope that she doesn't die because I want to see the way that she reacts to like the life that Denji grew up in. What exactly like what he was given, the reason why he likes this. If you grow up with pretty much nothing, when you get something, like you appreciate things way more. Like when you just are able to actually say you have somewhere to call home, you actually have some like place that you can go to and you're gonna be able to eat every day. It's probably a really good feeling. Like, come on. But she doesn't know that. I mean, I'm sure she would understand if he, but he's just talking to her. He's like, all this thinking is making my brain just like overheat. And she's like, yeah, let's go cool off. And Denji is like low key doing all these like smooth moves leading up into all these new checkpoints. They end up going to the pool. She just starts getting undressed. And I like that when she's taking her shirt off, you just got that like peek over in the panel, like Denji's like freaking out. And he's like, I don't really know, like taking off your clothes to go swimming, it's kind of naughty. He actually doesn't know how to swim, so she's trying to swim. And he's like looking at her just in underwear, and he's like, I could kind of get the appeal of swimming. Again, he's unknowingly just doing all these smooth moves, like leading up to all these like extra spots for him. I really like that about it. I really like that he's doing this all unintentionally, and it's just going really well for him. But then Reza just gets she just gets fully naked. She's just ready for it. She's ready going skinny dipping with the guy. She's clearly got her end game like intention set. Unless she's secretly a devil doing something wild and crazy, then she wants to get a little bit of the chainsaw right there. Not the actual chainsaw. Probably just it's natural chainsaw. Let's go with that. But I really thought it was funny because like then she's like saying like I can't do this. I can't get naked here. It'll be unfaithful to Makima, but like at the same time he's like, damn, I can see her nipples. What do I do here? Oh, don't look below her waist. I can see everything. She's just because that was one thing she was saying. It's like, well, it's dark out, so we can't really see anything. But I mean, it's definitely light. I mean, you can see in the pool that there is, the reflection of moonlight, and it's not like it doesn't look pitch black. So here, then she is just getting made the fool of. Well, he's getting lured in because like that whole like double panel after that where he's like saying like I can't do this. I'll be unfaithful to Makima, and then the next panel without like any sign of like what would look like him moving, it's just like his clothes are off, and he's like, damn it, I've gotten one step closer. I gotta hold myself off, and here she is now trying to like trick him to get him the water. Not really trick him, just trying to like taunt him in. And at first she's just like talking about water, like saying it's cold, wants him to come in. Then she's pretending she's drowning. She's just trying to figure out what exactly to do. Ends up calling him a chicken, and then here he is jumps in. And you just get like a really like nice innocent like well maybe not innocent. You get that nice young love kind of like layout between them. Because this seems like something from, I don't know, some teen romance, because I guess that's really what it's going for. But it's not really teen romance by the end of it, because like they're just having fun. She's teaching him how to swim. It starts raining, and then she, they go inside, and you get a question from her. She's asking if you'd rather be a town mouse or a country mouse. And it peters over to Aki, who's with the angel devil, and explaining essentially the whole premise is to get the country mouse who. It's safer because you're not living near as many people. You're away from a lot of like they say cats, but I'm like in the country though. You're still gonna get like owls and stuff. I mean, I guess maybe like the gap's different. It's probably not there's as many owls to cat ratios in the city. And she's saying like you're trading up safety versus like a town mouse has like more food. Like it's a more exciting life. And you're just training out those kind of like risk reward type situations. Denji says he'd rather be the town mouse because there's better food and a lot more stuff to do. There's a lot more fun. And when she said, Reza asked him, it's like, is food and fun all you care about? And he's like, yeah, that is all I care about. Again, he doesn't know what she's doing. He doesn't know what kind of like games that setting them up for. And now he's saying like they're gonna, she wants to go to a local festival with him the next day. They're gonna have some more fun stuff, they're setting up a date, and then she's gonna run to the bathroom really quick, and Denji's just being absorbed in her cuteness. He's just being absorbed in her fun personality, very spontaneous, very energetic, very fun. And while she's going though, behind her, because I'm saying it felt like a teen romance, and then the last like couple pages turn into like a teen slasher because like as she's walking, she's like, oh, Denji, are you following me? And it's the guy saying that that he's Denji, and he's also gonna go to the bathroom. So he's like, let's go to the bathroom together. And here it is, the guy who's contracted with the Typhoon Devil, he's got his knife out, and he's only like 8 feet from her. And I'm the reason I'm worried is because the author from this track record, both in this series as well as Fire Punch, he's not one to keep characters that don't have like deep significant values alive. And I worry that we're gonna get a situation like there's actually a similar situation going on right now in Jujutsu Kaisen, because early in the series, and this will be oh it's one spoiler, it's not like a big thing. There was a character named Junpei, and he ended up becoming friends with the main character, and he was like, sweet, cool, I got a pretty close buddy now. And it was pretty nice. He had someone to talk to, he had a friend outside of his crazy world of fighting monsters. And then That dude ended up getting kind of like coaxed in by one another villain. Well, a villain ended up turning the dude into a villain, and it seemed like it was going to go down that kind of like, your friend goes down a darker road kind of thing. But then he ends up dying, and you get a situation where the main character, he loses something important to him. But right now, there's another character that shows up that he used to know back in like middle school, and it seems to be this girl has a thing for him. And I'm worried that she's gonna end up getting in a similar situation. Whereas, like, the main character for them, it's like, he lost somebody before. Maybe this is gonna be like with this girl, it's gonna be like, I'm not gonna let this guy kill another person I care about. And I'm wondering if we're gonna get something like that for Denji and Reze, because with here, with this, Denji, he's had worries about his heart. We know he's got, for the most part, he's really optimistic. And here we could get something like him, if this dude ends up killing her, like if we actually see Denji like develop some hatred, some like straight aggression. Like he's wild in his Chainsaw Man form, but he's not like hateful. It's more just like a crazy dude on a loves to slaughter on a spree. Here we can see him like actually have that kind of situation presented to him of maybe we see kind of like a bloody berserker, kind of like Denji for a bit. And not, again, not like fun berserker, just like pissed off, like unhinged. As it even says it, like the very last panel, he's like closing his eyes, thinking, and he sees two different girls. He sees both Makima and Reze in his like mind. So he's obviously fallen for both of them. Thing though, I'm hoping, my hope here is that it's being more set up that she can be his love interest. Since Makima, it's never gonna happen, and I still suspect that she's gonna become a villainess. Again, we will see. I'm worried. I don't want anything to happen to this girl. I like her character already. I think she's interesting. She could easily become something more in the future for both, for both Denji as well as like a character. Maybe she could get her own contract. Maybe she could become like, a hybrid devil person, kind of like Denji. I don't know. It'd be interesting. Like, what if something happens? Like, they end up defeating this. Slasher dude, and for some situation, maybe she doesn't know that Denji is not as immortal, and she tries to form a contract with him, and she has to have a contract with the Typhoon Devil. I don't know, something along the lines of, further for a character. I'm just really hoping she just doesn't die here. So we'll see. We got 9 days now because it was an early chapter this week. I actually don't know why early chapters were this week. I know the last time we got an early chapter release a couple weeks ago was because it was a holiday in Japan. Expect your Elder's Day or something. I don't know the exact one. But layout is some interesting stuff. Again, they have some really nice chemistry, and Denji deserves it. Like he's had a really shitty life, and the last like girl that he met that it was really nice to him ended up, losing her life to a ghost devil who was ready to fully like completely fine with her dying, just to, deal with the situation. But that's because the devil. But anyway, comment below. Tell me what you thought about this chapter. Again, I really am hoping things go well for Denji. I really do. I mean, it would serve like an interesting kind of like progression for his character, for him to experience some heavy loss, or him just experience like really like rage. But I don't want this character to die. Maybe she could get messed up, like she could get like slashed, and maybe just leave scars. But maybe lives. I mean, listen, change. You can't say like, oh, you never want a character to die. The thing is, you get like a situation like that, and it's like you don't want this character to die because just shipping stuff. I don't want this character to die in Chainsaw Man because every time we get a really nice character in the last 40 chapters, they end up dying. We've lost so many characters already. I'm happy that Gobeni still exists. Like, right, she didn't die as well. So tell me in the comment section below what you thought about this chapter. Again, it has this really just nice chemistry with each other. It looks like they're just having a fun time. Denji is just having some life experiences. He's having that teenage like fun with the girl. So, let's just hope that it keeps going for him. You don't need Makima for Denji. I don't want to see his heart broken by Makima one day. And Power and him have like good kind of like chemistry as like a duo, but then I don't know if there's ever gonna be anything romantic between them. Denji specifically deserves some romance at some point. Anyway, yeah, thumbs up the video, press the like button and subscribe button, and check out my other videos. From that, I appreciate it. Subscribe, and thank you all for listening. Bye.